Year 1971. In the month of August, the Indian Navy transferred INS Vikrant, its aircraft carrier, to the Eastern Naval Command in Vishakhapatnam. That forced the Pakistan Navy to adjust its submarine operations. PNS Ghazi was the only submarine of the Pakistan Navy that had the range and capability to undertake operations in the distant waters controlled by India. November 13. All the ships of Indian Eastern Command, including INS Vikrant, set out for the Andaman and Nicobar Islands. November 14. PNS Ghazi quietly sailed 3,000 miles around the Indian Peninsula from the Arabian Sea to the Bay of Bengal under the command of Zafar Muhammad with 10 officers and 82 sailors. November 16. Ghazi was in contact with the Navy headquarters and Commander Khan charted the coordinates that reported she was 250 miles off Bombay. November 19. She was off to Sri Lanka and entered in Bay of Bengal on 20th November. Around this time, the top secret files were opened. Ghazi was on a two-fold mission. The primary goal was to locate and sink INS Vikrant, and secondary was to mine India's eastern seaboard, which was to be fulfilled irrespective of the accomplishment of the first. Thus, the hunt for Vikrant began on 23rd November, and Ghazi was off to Madras. Same day, President Yahya Khan declared a state of emergency in all of Pakistan and told his people to prepare for war. November 25. The Navy headquarters communicated with Ghazi, stated, Intel indicates carrier in port Vishakhapatnam. November 26. Ghazi was expected to communicate with the Navy headquarters to submit its mission report but did not communicate with its base. The Navy headquarters repeatedly made frantic efforts to establish the communication, and anxiety grew as days passed for her return to the base. On 1st December 1971, Vice Admiral Neelakanta Krishnan briefed Captain Inder Singh, the commanding officer of INS Rajput, that a Pakistani submarine had been sighted off the Sri Lankan coast and was absolutely certain that the submarine would be somewhere around Madras or Vishakhapatnam. He made it clear that once Rajput had completed refueling, she must leave the harbor with all navigational aids switched off. What happened between 25th November and 4th December is a mystery. But both sides are agreed on this, that on the night of 3 or 4th December 1971, Ghazi sunk with all 93 servicemen on board under the mysterious circumstances of the Vishakhapatnam coast. December 9, just after the sinking of INS Khukhri, the Indian Navy issued a statement about the fate of Ghazi. Indian Naval Headquarters claimed sinking of Ghazi on the night of 3 December. India also claimed that the INS Rajput was responsible for the sinking the Pakistan Navy submarine Ghazi. Pakistani military oversights into this incident were not immediate. Instead, the Naval Intelligence took time to conclude its investigations that went on for several years. Over the decade, the military oversights were kept hidden and were not known to the public. Pakistan rejected India's claim of sinking Ghazi by INS Rajput and termed the claim as false and utterly absurd. Many Indian military officers and experts were also skeptic about the Indian claim that INS Rajput had sunk Ghazi. Most of them agreed that Ghazi had sunk under mysterious circumstances. In 1972, the United States offered to raise the submarine to the surface at their expense. The government of India, however, rejected this offer and allowed the submarine to sink further into the mud of the fairway buoy of Vishakhapatnam. In 2010, it was reported that Indian Navy had destroyed all records of sinking Ghazi submarine. Vice Admiral G.M. Hiranandani, who was tasked with writing the official history of the Navy, stated that he was unable to obtain any old files regarding PNS Ghazi sinking. Those old files were destroyed One of the retired Navy officer who saw the action in 1971 said that the destruction of the Ghazi papers and those of army in Kolkata depicts the many instances when Indian war history has been deliberately falsified. Who destroyed the Ghazi? Was it an accident or was a result of some technical failure?